Only 5 seconds of gameplay footage exists of this game console. The Emprator, released in 2014, claimed to rival big names like PlayStation, but that couldn't be further from the truth. And no, it wasn't made in China, but rather in Iran, where it was exclusively sold. Even here, it was extremely hard to find. Inside the box, you'll find a racing wheel, webcam, cable, manual, and a DVD containing 9 games. So you're probably asking, where's the game console? Everyone refers to it as a console and the TV commercial shows something, but in the end, they never finished it and the games were ported to PC. The webcam is supposed to track the wheel and use it as game controls. That's nothing new. So what's so special about this one? Let's find out in the 9 games it came with. I tried to install the games, but one of the files requires a password and the other asks for a serial number. Nowhere, and I mean nowhere, is there a mention of a serial number. The person I bought this from couldn't even set it up, the company doesn't exist anymore, and there's no information online. Is there even an actual game or is it like the console itself? To find out, I had to crack the game I bought and own. I hopelessly opened Cheat Engine, and to my surprise, the code for the serial mechanism is not only visible, but there are instructions on how it works as well. If you enter the correct key, the setup proceeds to the next page, and if not, it displays an error message. I remove the second part of the code and replace it with the first one so I can proceed even by entering the wrong key. There's no way it's that easy, but that actually worked. Legitimate users can't get past this anti-piracy measure, and yet you can bypass it with zero coding experience. Who'd wanna pirate this shit anyways? After 9 years, I'm the only person uploading it to the internet. Go check it out if you think I'm making this up. After the setup finishes, the game automatically opens up to a massive ear rape, which I lowered in the video. Before playing, you can test the webcam and the wheel. The webcam uses the pattern printed behind the wheel and calculates its rotation over 3 axes. So yeah, the wheel is just a useless piece of plastic. Couldn't they use an accelerometer like the Wii that came 8 years before it? And the webcam is even worse, just look at this quality. Even the instruction video and the box itself are showing different webcams, but let's see how it plays out in the actual games. The first game on the list is called The Car. It features 9 of them, along with 4 tracks. This is my first time playing. At first, the wheel seems to work fine. And then it doesn't. It's extremely inconsistent and the car only turns whenever it wants to. Even when it works, there's like half a second of delay. The webcam is horrible when it comes to fast movements and quickly loses track of the pattern. On top of that, you have no control over throttle or brakes. If you get stuck, you have to restart. I don't even know how good the game is because I'm still struggling with the controls. You have to keep the pattern inside the webcam's tiny field of view for it to be registered, which is really difficult since the wheel isn't mounted. This circle is present in every game to make aligning the wheel easier, which you have to do a lot. You have to focus both on the gameplay and on the pattern not moving out of the circle. Even if you get it right, this is no fun. You need brakes, less input delay, ability to do quick corrections, larger webcam FOV, and just being able to properly turn. You can do none of these. The car is undrivable with the wheel, period. But maybe the next game is better. It's called Mirrors. And that's what it is, just a mirror with different video effects. This is something you do on a phone, why put it on a game console? You can't even take pictures, what's the point? The best thing to come out of it is this meme-worthy screenshot laughing at your life decisions. Let's move on. The third game is actually the best one. It's River Raid from Atari. Yep, a game made 40 years ago is actually more enjoyable than anything else here. They copy-pasted the whole game and made it even worse. The river can now randomly end without any indication at the beginning. The level designer is literally trolling you. They even had the audacity to replace Activision with their own company's name. Playing it with the Emprator wheel is just as unresponsive and inconsistent as the car game. This time, however, you can shoot by rotating the wheel forward. Couldn't they do this to the car for braking? Moving on. The fourth game doesn't work. It requires you to move the pattern further away from the webcam, and when you do, it becomes unrecognizable because the picture quality is just so bad. You need lots of light for it to be barely picked up, and even then it's unplayable. This is the worst way of teaching colors to kids. So on to the fifth game, where the goal is to use blocks to build a tower as high as possible without it falling apart. It's a simple concept, but this is something you'd play on a phone or as a flash game. The sixth game is called The Ship in Darkness. You're supposed to dodge enemy ships that come from either right, center, or the left of the screen. However, the screen eventually turns black and you have to use the stereo speakers to tell where the next enemy ship is coming from. So yeah, this is a game with no graphics or visuals, just sound and a black screen. At least there's less ear rape in this game. The seventh game is probably the nicest looking, but as for gameplay, you're just picking up balls that match the color of your ship. You pick up fruits to recharge the ship and junk food lowers your energy? I don't care if you want to educate kids, that makes no sense. I don't have enough balls to play this game any further, so on to the 8th game, and I'm only going to show still images because it can actually cause motion sickness. The goal is to rotate the level and guide this ball through a hole. It's another mobile game containing 18 levels that are super easy. The biggest problem, however, is that it's so disorienting, it causes headaches within 10 minutes. I never experienced anything like this with any video game. It's like reading a book in a moving car, if you know what I mean. I wouldn't mention it if it wasn't for the fact that these games were approved by the Ministry of Health. Video games were seen as dangerous back then, and they still proceed to approve one without even playing it. They clearly didn't even test it. How did it win awards? The final game is Ring and Wire, which shouldn't have been made into a video game. Not only you can't move the camera, but the depth perception is just not there on a 2D screen. As per every game, the controls are terrible on the wheel and I'm using keyboard for the most part. Yeah. First it was a game console, then it became webcam games, and now it's just games. At this rate, you might as well not call them games. You just wasted 2 weeks worth of minimum wage on nothing. It's a scam. Even in the TV advertisement, they're using a keyboard. The steering doesn't match, the kid is just acting. I wonder where they learned that from. But anyways, the car game becomes playable with keyboard since you can accelerate and brake using the arrow keys. Once you get rid of the horrible controls, you start to notice how awful the game is. First of all, the car and track used in the cover are cut from the game, and all you do is collect company logos before the timer runs out. The cars have lots of grip and are extremely easy to drive. They would have provided no challenge if it wasn't for the inconsistent and glitchy physics. The optimization is just as bad, and the camera is even worse. It takes way too long to follow the car, and the sense of speed is non-existent. The problems in this game can fill another video, so I'll end it here. And that's everything the Emprator had to offer. From the console that never existed and defective DRM, to impractical controls and headache-inducing games. The best thing about it was a game ripped off from a console 6 generations before it. I don't think you can go lower than this, so what really went wrong? Given how little information there is about it, we had no answers. Until the original creator did an interview 5 months ago. At first, the main issue seems to be money. They had no investors prior to the console's release. Only around $9,000 from the government, of which they ended up receiving half. A budget only enough for simple games, but that doesn't excuse it because the main idea was outdated in the first place. They wanted to get kids away from the screen and involve physical movement, like Kinect, or Wii, PlayStation Move, or any actual racing wheel. They did nothing to innovate or improve. Sony's PlayStation 2 iToy came 10 years before, and the games on it were actually decent. Especially for a first attempt at webcam games. Both devices had the same cost. The Emprator has no excuse to be inferior in every way despite being much newer. They even wanted to make a second version with more games. Why? When the console was finished, they finally found an investor. It was a publishing company called The Emprator. That's how it got its name. Their website is called Emprator Japan, but it was an Iranian company importing outdated Chinese consoles. And along with deceptive marketing, it explains why this one mistakenly became known as a game console. Both the Emprator company and the actual creators of the console eventually closed offices and the website is no longer up. So I bought it. For the first time in 9 years, these abominations of games can now be downloaded from this website. Hopefully we can learn from it and never make the same mistake ever again. But we didn't. We took that mistake and made it even worse just a year later. Next time, we're gonna see what happens when a government-backed studio makes a game with propaganda added on top.